Thank you so much, Professor Avasthi.
Avanish.
Professor Avanish and my fellow speakers on the dais and friends. I know I reached a bit early because I gave time for the traffic calculations. Today, surprisingly, traffic was better. So, I never criticized traffic of Mumbai, but we receive criticism about traffic of Mumbai. And we are held responsible for that. So, I reached early, and I was expecting young guys like you to be in time for the lecture. But I was told that as you are young, you are late, always. I was remembering my days. I think the days have changed a lot. We always live in a time which is changing very fast. The city is also changing. The topic of today is city in transition. See, any city, or for that matter, any society always evolves. Sometimes the pace is slow, sometimes the pace is very fast. Sometimes the pace is as slow that the city starts dying. This was not told about Mumbai city, but this was sometimes captioned about Kolkata, saying that Kolkata was dying. I don't know whether you have gone through such articles, news articles about that, when seriously it was being debated whether Kolkata was dying or not. So it happens about different cities at different points of history, that city has evolved so slowly that it has lagged behind the pace of development and the increase in population and what with that, whatever the demands have been increasing in the city from the infrastructure side or the services side. And so the same thing happened with Mumbai. At one point of time, if you remember, Mumbai, when it developed from seven islands to a city, and Mumbai Municipal Corporation's limit was up to Mahim Causeway. That time people say that everyday roads used to be washed in Mumbai. Okay. At least I have heard about it because I worked for 4.5 years as additional municipal commissioner in Mumbai Municipal Corporation. And we were told about those glorious past when the roads in Mumbai used to be not only swept but also washed every day, cleaned with water. So that was the level of city maintenance at one point of time. And when city started growing, Bandra, you go to the Bandra Assistant Commissioner's ward office, you will see that the old level there says about the municipal council's name. So then Bandra and Andheri and then Dahisar, up to that point we grew, and here up to Mulund. So the city grew, but at the same time the organization remained concentrated in the old building of Municipal Corporation of Mumbai. So probably with that, the suburbs when they grew and the population explosion which took place, with that the pace of development of communication, of transport did not happen that way. We are talking a lot about nowadays BEST going down, where the public transport share of passenger traffic per day has gone down from 75% to 68% or 65%, around that. So earlier in Mumbai, with local trains and BEST buses, 75 to 78% people were traveling. Yeah. Now it has come down to 65%. Why it is so? It is not so because the gross number has gone down. It is because the population has increased so much, and so there have been so much increase in the passenger traffic every day that there is no space left in the public transport system, mainly the local trains. And that's why the people who are surplus have come on the road and have bought more cars to go around places for their livelihood, for their studies, for their work, that the traffic on the road has increased. But at the same time, if you see BEST passenger carrying capacity has not increased, at the same time that it has the opposite is true, it has gone down. For that, to certain extent, management itself is responsible, and the poor management, it has not been able to cope up with the demands of the new generation, population explosion and all. So this is the challenge in which we are at present living. Still, you will see that it's better than Delhi so far as public transport performance is concerned. Mumbai with 65% people traveling by public transport is much higher than any city in the country. But what is happening in the local trains, if you see yourself, and some of you might be traveling every day, per square meter of area there are 12 persons traveling, which is a very inhuman condition in which people travel in suburban trains. So that's why it is called that Mumbai is bursting at its seams, because the capacity of public transport, which carries maximum people in this city, is awfully inadequate vis-a-vis the demand of the city and population. In such a situation, what happened, what the state government did about metro development, I just gave you the scenario in which we are working, the context in which we are working, and why there is a need to not evolve but to pace our transition to such a level that it in few years to come you are able to change the city. And that is what we are doing. At one point of time, when Metro 1 was developed, it took city and city administration and government 10 years almost to develop one line. Mostly cities go by this speed, and not mostly this speed, but they go by one or two lines at one point of time. At present, we are developing 12 lines, 12 metro lines at different levels of development and decision making. 150 kilometers is being constructed in this city, actually on the site, and another 150 kilometers will start construction in next 1 year or so. No other city in the world is constructing metro at such a speed at which we are doing it. This is not my finding. This one day I received a call from Consul General of United States, and he said that, Mr. Commissioner, do you realize that you are doing metro? Tell me which other city is constructing so much of metro in the world. I don't find any, and I'm searching an searching a answer to that. I'm not finding any. So you are basically doing the maximum length anywhere in the world that much at one point of time. I know this creates a lot of implementation issues. It creates a lot of the pace with which we are going at present. We are finding difficult for others to keep pace with us in that development. We are finding it difficult to get more and more contractors, good contractors, to come and work for us. There is dearth of contractor also. There is dearth of finance also. But we are doing this. We are transiting this phase in a fast pace. Why? Because if you do one line, you do not change the behavioral pattern of citizens in this city. You cannot change that they will, you will execute one line and you expect people to shift from car to metro. You cannot, because one line will take you from one point to another, or on the line, on that route, other stations. Till you establish the complete network of metros in this city, you cannot expect a behavioral change in public. And that's why, that's the reason that we are stretching ourselves, burning our candle at both ends to implement this. We know that financially, physically, capacity wise, we are stretching ourselves. We are creating hurdles in crossing roads for people everywhere in the city. The traffic has become slower and slower. All aspects are accepted. All these side effects are acceptable. But if in next 5 years, you are going to see more than 200 kilometer of metro network operational in this city, a 22 kilometer of Mumbai Trans Harbour link operational in the city, which connects Navi Mumbai Airport to South Mumbai. If you see the Navi Mumbai Airport also operational, and if you see the coastal road and the new sea link from Versova to Kandivali also coming up, all these networks you expect in next 5 years, you can think of a city which will be completely changed. Imagine that city, visualize that city which will be completely changed. With that, what she was talking about the part of equitable, equipolis, which is the seminar here. How are we going to ensure that? One thing, by implementing public transport, you are making city more equitable. Because mostly the travel experience of people who at present are traveling with 12 persons in one square meter of area will come down to almost say 6 to 8 persons in one square meter of area of travel. That experience people will have. That will improve the quality of life of people so far as traveling is concerned in this city. At the same time, at present, around 70% of congestion is happening on the road. We expect that, and there is a study to that, we expect that by implementing these metro lines, will be reducing almost 25% congestion from the road. With the reduction of 75% of congestion to 50% congestion, will be achieving the congestion level of almost London, where the average traffic speed, average car speed is around 16 kilometer an hour. At present in Mumbai, the average car speed is around 9 kilometer an hour. So from 9 kilometer to 16 kilometer will be the achievement. And if the coastal road, MTHL and the sea link, you connect, you add to that infrastructure, the congestion is expected to go down by another 10-15%. And that will reduce, that will increase the average speed of cars on road, Mumbai roads, by from 16 to 33 kilometer an hour, because the congestion level will get reduced to the level of Tokyo. In Tokyo, the average speed is around 33 kilometer an hour. So that's what we are aiming for. So next 5 to 10 years, Mumbai 10 years maximum, if you take all the old experiences of project implementation in this city, whereas we have completely changed the way we have constructed line 7 and line 2A in last 2 years is an example to that, the speed with which we are constructing. But even if you take that, it will not happen in next 5 years. Certainly it is going to happen, because no one can change this way the development is now taking place. Whichever will be the government will have to implement these, because they are already on the road of implementation. So this process cannot be reversed now. So now, if this process cannot be reversed, at the max and the most pessimistic assessment can give you another 10 years of implementation of this project. So today we are in 19, maximum 27, 28, 29. All these developments will take place, and Mumbai will be a completely changed city by that time. This, having said that, one more thing I would like to say, and it's there that I come back to the issue of Equipolis. We are planning with the development of stations and all these nodes of public transport, transport oriented development planning, which is called TOD, the concept of TOD. Whereas people want to travel by metro, for example, if you find a very good shopping mall or a public place on a metro station, and there is a shopping mall and a public place away from metro station, where will you go? Generally, you will visit, you will come out of the station, you will go to that shopping mall, but do your shopping and go back from your metro station to your home. This is what generally people will do. So this is called TOD concept, transport oriented development. So this is what we are creating, and the most important component of that is going to be public space, creation of public space. More and more public spaces will be created, which will be like the refurbishment of Marine Drive was done long back, 10 years back or so, by MMRDA. That Marine Drive today, if you see, is one of the most equitable place in Mumbai. If you go and do the social survey of those people who are frequenting Marine Drive in the daytime, you will find that it's the most equitable place. That's open place. No one pays to go to that place. And it's very near to Cherney Road. It is very near to Churchgate Station and all those stations. So this is an example of a TOD development. With that, this type of concept we are implementing for development of different public transport nodes at different places, that is at the planning stage. If that comes up, the quality of life in Mumbai will be completely different. I think I should stop here, and I have given enough ideas to you so that you can generate questions on that. I'll be happy to answer those questions. Thank you so much.